some 23 churches or so, you still need to know that I was working with a weakness.
Yes,
I was the great apostle, and yes, all of these things happened, but you need to know I was still working with a great weakness. And people said, well, it was this, it was that, it was this. I'm not even here to try to extrapolate or exegete or try to give you an understanding of what it was. That's not what's important. Not for this context. What you just need to know is that it was a messenger of Satan that was sent to buffet him in his flesh. We all have that. Whether it is persecution, people lying on you, people being jealous of you, people being envious, whether it's a crappy relationship, whether it's toe up financial responsibility, or whatever it is, somebody, a lot of bodies need to know that that's what you're facing.
Yeah.
And that's where the devil tricks us. He drives us into isolation and silence, and we die out there by the sin.
Yes.
Well, you'll never have that problem with me because I told everybody.
Yeah.
I told everybody. I told everybody. Everybody that would listen, I told them. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
This is how the enemy tricks us.
Yes.
To make us ashamed of our infirmities.
Right.
Paul said, no, I boasted in my infirmities. This is where I'm struggling. This is where I suck. I need you to watch, cover, pray, stand in the gap. You need to know what's going on. See how quiet that is? See how quiet you got right there? See how that went? That was a drill. I went after that with a drill. I went way down into your childhood and made an adjustment.
Come on now.
I just dropped an anchor right down in your childhood and I made an adjustment. I promise you right now that word I just deposited is going to disrupt some bad erroneous teaching from your childhood that makes you feel you can't talk to nobody. I just dropped an anchor right there. There is Satan in the multitude of counsel.
Yeah, yes.
Two can tie themselves up, but three, a threefold cord.
Cannot be broken. Right.
You better find you some folk.
Right.
You better talk to your leadership. You better find you some people that can hear where you are and stand in the gap for you and pray for you. That you be healed.
Amen.
Amen.
Let's look at that. Let's go back to James. Are you there?
Yes.
Praise God. We're all abounding in grace. We're all grace growing. And it's not so much us growing as much as grace is growing in us.
Yes.
Amen. James chapter number 5. And let's look at verse number 16. And we'll close it here for tonight. Let's just see. And when you get there, say, I'm there.
I'm there.
Let's read verse number 16 again. 1, 2, 3. Confess trespasses or sins to one another and pray for one another that you may be healed. Let's read that one more time. 1. Confess. Uh-huh. Yes. Uh-huh. Now, I love the camaraderie of the text. That is not just, if you go back up to verse number 14, it says, if anyone is sick among you, let them call for the elders of the church. So there's a higher level of accountability if there is a disease or infirmity or sickness that's in operation. But in your weaknesses or your sins, you don't even have to go to an elder. You can go to one another. See, this is why the community of faith that we call the local church is so important.
Yes.
Amen. Who you have communion with, who you worship with, should be your confidants.
Right. Yeah. Amen. Yeah.
I just said something. Now, wait, you say, why? See, remember now, James is talking to people that are in one vocal body. And sometimes you start talking to your beautician or start talking to other people outside the church, they don't necessarily know what you're being taught. And so everybody doesn't approach things the same way. If I can have communion with you, I can confess to you.
Yeah.
Yes.
Wow.
If I can go to the Lord's table with you, then I can tell you my sins.
Yes.
I just dropped an anchor.
Yes, you did.
That spirit of distrust. That spirit of fear, that spirit of dislike.
Yes.
I don't trust nobody. I don't talk to them niggas. I don't talk to them. They always talk. They talk too much. You need to find somebody in the same body that you can confess to. And let me tell you something. I have a group of accountability people in this church. I'm talking about me. That I made myself accountable. That I say, hey, this is where I am. This is what's going on. And y'all pray for me. Y'all cover me. Now, you would think that the bishop would be going to another bishop. No. I came right in the house. Said, now, this is where I am. This is what's going on. Now, if I can do it, why you can't? What you got so great, so deep, so big. See, that spirit, that's a spirit of orphan. That's that spirit of orphan. That spirit of orphan does not want siblings. Y'all didn't say that. They don't want no brothers and sisters. They want to be an only child.
Oh. Wow.
That spirit of orphan does not connect well on that level. Because now it has to be honest. It has to be even and equal. If I go up and maybe I got a little authority, a little title, then I don't have to be as vulnerable and as transparent. See, I have to be as vulnerable. If I'm growing up, you know, I'm elder, you are elder, you're the friend of God. But if I come down on the low level, I got to be honest. I got to be naked with you. And the spirit of orphan don't want siblings. They don't want sisters. So you see them operate totally isolated. That's the spirit. And the spirit behind it is fear. Never been taught to share. Never been taught to eat out of one another's plate. Never been taught to drink behind one another.
Oh, y'all like that.
But you was by yourself. You didn't have to go behind them. You finish. And you bring that over to the context of faith. Amen. You don't like siblings. You don't want sisters and brothers. You want to be a mother, but you don't want to be a sister. And you don't want to be a daughter. You want to be a father, but you don't want to be a brother. And you don't want to be a son.
Wow.
You're an orphan.
Oh my God. Oh.
And the problem with orphan spirit is that you can never tap into the body. Because every joint supplies the other.
Yes. Every.
So when you are an orphan, you can't get what's coming to you, and the person standing on the other side of you can't get what's coming from you, because you are totally disconnected. That's the spirit of fear. Manifest is the spirit of order. No siblings, spontaneous birth, no parent, but yet you want to be a spiritual mother or spiritual father. But you really can't birth nobody, because you can't birth till you lay down with someone. Can't conceive till you lay down with someone. You ain't going to get pregnant with God. You gotta lay down with somebody.
Oh my God.
If you gonna conceive.
Amen.
Yeah. So you gotta connect. God got this thing already set up. That if you're gonna be a father, you must first be a daughter. You must be a sister. You cannot be a mother. And people call you stuff. You my spiritual mother. You my, you know they lying. You ain't birthed them.
Wow.
Oh my God.
You ain't birthed them. But there's so many orphans out here that they'll attach themselves to you. Social media, Periscope, Facebook. You ain't never met them. And you somebody's spiritual father. see how the devil will lie to you?
Yeah. Kill it.
That's a lie. But there's so many orphans in the Bible. Without, they'll never be accountable to you. They'll never submit to you. And they probably got 10 more people that they say the same thing. Because you can't do it long distance.
Wow.
You gotta have intimate relationships.
Yes.
You gotta see my weaknesses. These people out here, they know my weaknesses. These people that serve me, they know my weaknesses. They know my vulnerabilities. That's what makes you a spiritual parent. Not the information you share. That's just the teacher. We have many teachers. But you ain't no father. You ain't no father. Because you ain't put your bank in nobody. You ain't shot no sperm in nobody to have that baby.
No!
That's a lie. Unless there's some new way to do it. Did I didn't get the memo? And please don't send me that memo. Not now. I want to make sure that that's there for the next 50,000 years in Jesus' name. So that when I come into my manifestations, oh, shape I'm in. That's in place.
Yes.
Are y'all in place? But there's so many orphans out there. Don't nobody want to confess their sins to one another. Don't nobody want to confess their trespasses. Don't nobody want to lie down together. Nobody wants to be intimate and say, this is where I am. This is, this. Yeah, you see the face of the priest. You see the face of the lion. But let me show you my human face.
Yeah.
And I don't know if you love me, if you can love me human.
Yeah.
Because you may love me in my priesthood. You may love me. When you see my faith, my boldness, taking mountains, you may love me then, but can you love me human?
Yeah.
Right. Can you love me when you see my stretch marks? Can you love me for real?
That's right.
Yeah, but I just say, you know, nobody magic today.
Yes.
It's just too hot. Can you still love me? So that's why we have this counterfeit stuff going on in church. Because ain't nobody really for real. Everybody fake. Everybody having a close relationship with the Lord. You got all kinds of stuff going on. But ain't nobody in the body where God is planted. In the body that you have been baptized into. In the body that you have been set in. You don't trust nobody. That's because we have created a false context of holiness that is really not genuine.
Yes.
I am working out my own salvation. I'm trying to get the groceries in here so y'all can shop.
Amen.
I'm trying to make sure that there's food in the refrigerator, food on the altar, trying to make sure that milk is on. Trying to make sure you got produce. Trying to make sure you got all the stuff that you need to grow into a healthy Christian. But while I'm shopping for you, hallelujah, I'm still working out my own salvation.
Yeah.
Fear and trip.
Yeah.
So that the excellency might be of God.
Amen.
Hey, I'm done. The word of God, the people of God, thanks be to God. Hallelujah. Come on, stand up. On your feet, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. This is why we need a personal Pentecost. This is why we need personal Pentecost. So we can be converted. Jesus said, Peter, I know you're walking with me. And I saw something.
Yeah.
I saw Satan trying to sit in his feet. And I prayed for it.
Oh my God.
I'm not going to take you out the group. I'm not going to kick you off the disciples' board. I'm not going to remove your apostolic ascension anointing and keep the keys that I gave you to the kingdom.
Wow.
Yes. I'm not going to sit you down and embarrass you. You're going to cuss me out. You're going to deny me. You're going to show out. But without our
commitment,
we are saved, but we are being saved. We are justified, but there is a being glorified. We are both and. We are saved and struggling. We are saved and fighting, fiercely fighting. But we are saved, justified by faith. But we now are being sanctified in our present human experience that we might be glorified. That we might receive the end of our faith, which is our salvation. Which is more precious than gold. That's the process. And we all in it.
Yeah.
Ain't nobody not in it. We all in it. So we may as well come on up in here and fight and struggle and worship and do it together.
Amen.
We better together.
Amen.
And when I go to the gym and you start talking about somebody or you judge somebody, there's a light that goes off.
Yes, sure.
And a siren. Planet of fitness. They hear you trying to laugh at somebody, they'll put you out. They'll come and get you and take you out.
Yes,
and a siren goes off.
Yes,
it's called a no judgment zone. No judgment zone. I want to decree in this house. Yes.
Hallelujah.
I come here with that. We all working out our salvation.
Amen.
Praise God.
Praise God.
I got some stuff that's excellent. I got some stuff that God is well pleased with. But at the same time, I got this thing over here.
Yeah.
Messenger of Satan. Sent above in me in my flesh.
Yes.
You better know. You better fight. You better not get into it. You better fight, but don't fight by yourself. Amen?
Amen.
Having escaped the corruption, so the divine nature is in you, to will and do, but you got to carve it out.
Yes.
That's why you need a prayer life.
Yes.
That's why you need time in the Word.
Yes.
That's why we come to church. That's why we sit here and hear the Word when it's 80 degrees outside and we all can be a bell eye.
Yes.
While we're here, we're working out our salvation.
Yes.
Father, we thank you.
Yes.
We give you praise for such a great salvation.
Yes.
Hallelujah. We give you praise.
Yes.
And even as we leave this place, the blood of Jesus will be traction to our times.
Yes.
The angels of the Lord shall go before us.
Yes.
And the great host of heaven shall come behind us.
Yes.
We thank you right now, O God, that the glory of the Lord overshadows us. Hides us. Blood of Jesus is over us.
Yes.
Hides us from the sniper, the rapist, the robber, the molester, the witch, and the warlock, the mobile demon. There'll be no accidents or incidents. There'll be no vehicular situations. We shall arrive to our destinations safely without incident. And when we get there, we rest our head up on the pillow. We'll say once again, God, you did it.
Yes.
Not by might or by power. But you did it by the Spirit. And we're so grateful.
So grateful.
And as soon as we get another opportunity, we'll run back to the house of God so we can rejoice again
with
the body that you planted us in. And we thank you for it, God. God, remember Elder John Dickerson tonight. In the name of the Lord Jesus. Remember him now as he's aging. Remember him, God, from the top of his head to the soles of his feet. Those that are out with sicknesses, maladies, and infirmities. Those that are facing life situations, Father, please remember them tonight by your precious Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name, amen.